Hey, what's up? It's Kid Ichigo. Back here to do another game off of Ichigo called McBat 64. This one I've seen around actually on the Switch for quite a while now. I didn't even really realize it was on Ichigo, but I got it in the Ukraine bundle that I got recently. Definitely been wanting to check it out since I saw it on Switch. I think it's a kind of like an old rare style, like 64 N64 platformer kind of a thing, like Donkey Kong 64 and stuff like that. So it definitely looked pretty cool. Wanted to check it out for a good amount of time now. Beginner's bar. Our boy McBat's about to set the bar.
Almost 2 years now.
We got voice acting? Shit.
Kiwiland was ruled by the evil Melon
King. Yeah, look at that model. Looks totally like a rare, like, fucking character out of, like,
brave enough to stop
the late 90s.
Reign of terror.
Flightless bird? Would it be?
And so the little
it is the Kiwi.
All of Kiwiland and the galaxy was at peace.
Oh, he didn't just save the world, he saved the whole galaxy. It's quite a feat for a little bird. Almost 2 years later, somewhere deep in the Kiwi Bean. I don't even know how you would try to say that. Okay. Now we're in it. One day I will guide a hero to victory without repeating myself. Get yourself a drink, me lad, and I tell you a great story. Oh, I can fly around because bat. I'm just here to collect some spare coins. Apparently that's what I'm here to do too. What is this guy supposed to be? I have the feeling that his last adventure was a bit too much for him. Talking about your Kiwi friend here. They said there were 60. 60, but all I could find were 59. My man drunker than a skunk. Oh boy, I can't wait for Legend of Bat 2. It's gonna be radical and only slightly worse than part 1. Usually how sequels go. If not catastrophically worse than the first one. I can't hear it anymore, I'm losing my appetite over his nonsense about the game. Jesus. Did he say Jesus because he's a rat? Fucking of course he did. Welcome to the grog pump, fellow adventurer. It is happy hour. Grog will only cost you 3 coins. What if I go up into the grog pump? You can start going up there, you can't continue on, unfortunately. I wanted to- oh! This is a door. I wanted to become Grog. Arrows. Y'all got a third coin in here? Am I supposed to- oh, this turns. Okay. I guess we're going in here then? I wanted to buy some grog, but that's fine. Sorry, but I can't let anybody down to the pump. I sometimes wonder if that camera would get dizzy when you run around it in circles. My man was right. Well, now that it's dizzy, like, can I just continue on? Oh yeah. Did we just fall in a vat of piss? What is this? Why is it yellow? I don't trust this thing. Oh, you made it all the way down here? What an impressive task. Please take this as my recognition. Go figure, we needed that. It only took traveling to the piss. Oh, that was the grog? Are you telling me the grog is that thing's piss? Here you go! Well, I got the grog now. Do you know where all the water in the world is coming from, m'lad? All our water is being produced in a place we call the Water Factory. The Watery Factory. Lately, however, the production has just stopped. Since the factory is sealed up, no one is able to go in and check what's up. Fortunately, I know the exact locations of all 6 keys needed, or almost exact. Unfortunately, this adventure will include a lot of running around, so what do you say, my lad? Dare to join me on a journey to save the Kiwibian? Kiwibian? It's like, 'cause you want to say it like Kiwi, but then if you say it like Caribbean, it's like Kiwibi, I don't know. What a beautiful night. Smoke up, boy. It's time to save the world, my lad. If you say so. I mean, I am just but a bat. A fancy bat with a monocle. How can... world completed? Like, how can one such as McBat be one to save the world? Alright, well, that was... very, very quick. Birdie Beach. Let's go into it. Bats and beaches don't mix. Look at our boy. Oh yeah, wow, this definitely has vibes of some like Donkey Kong 64 kind of thing. Arr, the sea is calm today. We are off to a good start. Guess I'll adventure around then. So am I just supposed to collect all the coins in the area? Is that kind of the gist of it? Dang it, I lost my insides. Could you find them for me? My insides are coins, relax. Yeah, I wouldn't want to have to get your guts back, son. That doesn't sound too fun. Let me see if I can make it around. I ate that balloon, so somewhere a kid will be very sad, mwahaha. I am so evil, what? I am evil for Squid's sake. Okay. I mean, you're also very dumb and unaware, because I just finessed your banana from you. What is this? Where? What does this do? I got like a pea shooter? Oh. So I'm supposed to get the balloons. Because he said he ate a balloon, so it's like, okay. There's one inside him, I guess. What? Am I supposed to deliver them somewhere? You can only carry one at a time, or... Yeah, I wonder what I do with these balloons. It's really nice here. I wish I had a beach level in my game, but oh well. Maybe in the next one. Whoa, thanks a lot for the banana here. You can have this in exchange. But I can't take it. Where do I take the balloons? You can turn your camera with Q and E. You can focus it behind you by holding the shift key. Oh. I guess that's where we're taking the balloons, in that case. I don't know what happens at the top of here, but about to find out. It is messing me up that it's not the mouse that moves the camera around. Need one more to lift it. It looks like. Let's see, where would this last balloon be? Oh, so you can actually go over there? Whoa! What's that? That's a secret. Secret secrets. Oh, maybe he gives me one? Well, thank you so much for bringing my coins back to me. Now I feel complete again. Thank you for the balloon, sir. I'm interested in what this key's about to do. The Kiwi key. Oh yeah, that's just how you complete the world. You look for the different keys, I guess. Alright, well, cool. Yeah, this is definitely like a cool little game. Definitely very short and sweet kind of levels, but not bad. It's pretty fun to just explore around, do a little collect-a-thon kind of a thing. Tulsar's Forest. Wonder how many stages there are in this game. Not sure how much of this game I will check out, but I definitely will just kind of go until, you know, it feels right to stop or whatever kind of a thing. But I don't think this will be too long of a video either way. Oh, I thought we just jumped on the chest before and it opened. But not still going on. It feels like a room, but it's supposed to be like a forest. It's kind of funny. For some reason, my soup tastes like metal. I have no idea why. Well, I guess that's for this. What? We got a shield? What do we have a shield for? A true hero needs a sword, a shield, and a very nice hat. Oh, don't look at me like that. The manual says so. Well, there's our shield. Here's our sword. And a very nice hat. By ROM, will I ever find the magical goblet of Tulsar? I've been looking for it for two movies by now. With this hat, you will look as fashionable as I do. Thank you, sir. It said it wants you to dress up like Link, and then the owl needs you to look like Link, and then you can go inside. All right. Am I actually going to get to use this thing, or is it just for looks? What are you? Oh. I thought maybe you did something with the blocks. Oh, we got some puzzles going on. Okay. Well, that was quite simple, but a little creepy. I don't love the face that just appeared on the wall. So we're dungeon crawling now? This game kind of changed pace a little bit. Who are you? Oh boy, this is a heavy one. You really need to push it long to get it to move. Well, I mean, that's nice of him to tell me that. They definitely hold your hand a little bit in this so far. Which is fine. It's definitely just a nice little cute, fun, easygoing kind of a game. I mean, so far, maybe there's something cursed or more cursed in this than is happening so far, but I need to figure out how. How we gonna do this? Oh, here we go. That worked out. Which way did I come in? I don't even remember. I think that way. Oh.
Looks like he needs some head. Hey, yo.
I didn't even see my, like... I got, like, a nice little vampire red and black tux going on. That's kind of... It's a cool little look for my man. Oh, we just teleport back out here. Where do I take this? Oh! I didn't realize he needed that. Okay. I guess, oh, he did say he was looking for something. I didn't put together that that's what it was for. Well, nice. Okay. We got him his goblet back or whatever. Now we can get fucked up on grog. Strangely familiar familiar jungle. I'm gonna see how many more stages there are. Looks like 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so there's a decent amount. And then like maybe one final level or something. Alright, well, yeah, I'm not sure how much of it I will get to. We'll probably, go for another, like, 15 minutes-ish. and then probably wrap up the video for now, but maybe I'll check out the rest of this in a second video at some point. Definitely pretty cool, though. Glad I'm checking it out. Just a fun kind of homage to, yeah, the old N64 Rare games, I believe. I don't like that these ghosts are giving me O-face. I don't love it. Okay, so we gotta collect balloons again. I love Roby Beanland for the game boss. Those windy tunes are the best. The game boss. That's a new one. Hey there, long time no see. Yeah, I lost them again. Don't look at me like that. My top is open, you know? Let's see, who are we going to give balloons to? I wonder if it's the same guy? Have you seen those ghostly balloons? They scare me. Someone should pop them. I said the same guy, but it's not a guy. Wait, how do we pop them? Let's see what this button does. Oh, he gets a little pair of scuba diver goggles on. He's prepared. McBad ain't no fool. Well, that just lowers the door, okay. It's as simple as that. But now, how do I pop these ghost balloons? I wonder. Well, let's go inside here, see what's going on. Second button and a second balloon. Oh, we can shoot those with the pea shooter. Gotcha. Let me get that pea shooter. See what happens when we pop all these ghost guys. This turned into a first-person shooter. And there's platforming elements, and there was a dungeon to dive in. There's dungeon crawling. What else is this game gonna offer? McBat has everything you could ever want. Another balloon. Oh, I didn't even see this one. Did this just appear right here, or was this always here? Wait, where are we gonna go, though? secret area? Dude, we got the secret. Or no, it's just the key. I thought maybe it was like a secret. In the hot sun like a fried banana. Marvelous. Well, you have voice acting. I wonder why most of the other like NPC dudes don't have voice acting, but this guy does. I guess the cool monkey man is, you know, definitely one that needed a voice. If anyone needed some voice acting dialogue, it was the cool monkey boy. Looks to me that you found a new friend, Kiwi. Fine. First him, then you, then Kiwi Land. Well, that sounds like a threat. So somebody is not very happy with our progress. Alright, past the strangely familiar jungle. Bright Islands? Is that just Wispy Woods with a mustache and different eyes? If Kirby on the Brain, the new Kirby game just dropped today, and definitely excited to play that at some point. Me and my girlfriend at One Arm Scissor are definitely going to be trying to stream that at some point. Oh, this literally seems... Is it going to be like side-scrolly kind of a deal? Even the music is like kind of Kirby-esque. Okay, well... Definitely see what they were going for. I guess helping this giant tree is our best way to find the key. Oh, I miss my poor little fruits so much. They fell far too early. Would you kindly bring them back to me? What if I viciously bring them back to you? How about that? Oh, no, yeah, this is definitely just like fucking... They set this up like Kirby and the Crystal Shards. Oh, that's what those do. Wait, is there a secret or something? Oh, we're just collecting all the fruits. It's even like the same apples from Kirby. Wow, okay. Yeah, the influence from the N64 era Nintendo stuff is definitely very, very, noted here. Pretty obvious who they had their influences from. What games and whatnot. This is cool that they make every level like kind of a different little thing going on. It's always kind of a collect-a-thon, but then every level kind of has a different style from, you know, those older N64 platformers and stuff. Whoa, what was that? Who's on the fucking blimp? It's Meta Knight. He's on his blimp. Fuck is this dude? Bomberman looking ass. Do I plug the hole? Plug in the hole, baby. That's what McBat is best at. Besides being fancy as fuck with his monocle. Oh, well, that was a tease. What an asshole. This blimp is such a dick. Oh, well. There you go, dude. Oh, I didn't even get to see what he said. Whoops. Oh, little bat, thank you so much. You helped me out a lot. You got them fruits, boy. Hooked him up with the fruits. Tubular City. This isn't the sickest shit I've ever seen, I swear to God. Oh hell yeah, we all got shades on? Of course we do. Now it just turned into like a... What the fuck? Completely changed aesthetics. Twin palms. I like the Rubik's Cubes. It's a nice touch. Yeah, McBat is apparently, into Vaporwave all of a sudden. And he's cool as fuck. Alright, let's go talk to all the NPCs. Man, it's boring around here. You know, if you can bring me 4 batteries, I can take you for a ride. So no more balloons, we're looking for batteries now. I'm looking for Sarah Connor, have you seen her? Shut the fuck up. That's so stupid. Wow. Oh, there's the other coin. Hey man, wanna try out my pad and show me them moves? Sure, let me get my money first and then I'll come over and humor you. Arcade games are hard. When you don't have hands, yeah. Can imagine so. This dude looks cool, I like this guy. I'm listening to Bear by Remute. This track is tubular, dude. I wonder if that's a real song. Do I really just bounce between the different green ones? Is it timed or anything? Like... Oh, nope. Easy as that. Got a battery. I just tried your pad out. It was cool though. I got the groovy. Also, he doesn't want them until we got all of them at the same time, I guess. Let me make sure there wasn't anything else up here. Battery-wise. Well, you can go up here. Oh no, it's got a invisible wall. I was like, it looks like they make you be able to go up there for some reason, but... It's the launch day of Legend of Bat 2, and I don't have enough money. Well, I collected all the coins. Do we not give them to him, I guess? Whoops. I just like clicked out of the game for a second, my bad. Shooting zombos? Wait, did I get a battery for that? Oh, I guess I got a battery for that. Okay. So now we just continue on into the mall or what? Thanks, dude. Enjoy your copy of the game. Now you're really playing with power. Well, we got Bat 2. It's literally just the Legend of Zelda 2 fucking cover. Okay, whatever. Is this all I have to do is finesse this guy? Yeah, got another battery. Hey, there's the last battery. Whoa, thanks, dude. That is tubular. Here, you can have this in exchange. Oh, that's what he said. It was just showing me. It, like, still had the dialogue and then it showed the car. Can't confuse me like that. What the hell? Wait, now we're... What the fuck? Now we're in... Okay, I do have to give it up to this game, like, just for having so many different... parts to it. There's so many different game mechanics and stuff in this, go figure. I was just expecting kind of a basic, you know, 3D platformer kind of a thing, but this has like a bunch of different little elements to it. It's pretty cool. Did we win? We evaporated into thin air. Okay, I guess that's what we were trying to do. The car just fucking disintegrated.
Whoa, what a ride.
I was supposed to be like, we were going so fast that we just like flashed on ahead.
Oh, now look at what we have here. One more key.
Well, yeah, I'm definitely interested because it keeps changing it up every time. Yeah. At this point, I mean, I was gonna probably wrap it up in not too long, but there's not like a whole lot left to do, so let's just see like how long each of these next few stages take or whatever, and now it's just Mario Kart. Okay, I feel like I have to stay and play this through, man. Well, that dude just, what the fuck? Blatantly cheated. There's even items, no fucking way. I am Giant Squid. I don't know what this does. Oh, we got 4 laps. They said you got one more than regular Mario Kart. Yeah, it's really impressive how every level is like a different spin on like an old N64 game kind of a thing. Definitely impressive. Just for like a fun, cute little game, man. Like, definitely glad I checked this out. I haven't gotten the boost yet, have I? Oh yeah, I have. Just automatically does it for you. Last lap, let's go. There are only, it seems, 2 power-ups though, but still, it's like, better than nothing, man. It shows you they tried. I respect it. Even the music kind of fits every little, like, stage that they were trying to mimic kind of a thing, yeah. Oh shit, the Kiwi boy was right behind me. Alright, completed that. Yeah, it seems like all of these different stages are just, like, pretty short and sweet, so at this point, if there's only, it looked like 2 or 3 more? Honestly, may as well just check them out. None of them have really taken too long here so far, so why not go check out the rest of it? Moody Mansion. We got that, then we got one more thing, and then we got this question mark one. It seems like that's everything, possibly. Just see how these next two go. What is this illustration? Me bones are shaking, my lad. Hurry up and find that key so we can get out of here. Alright, so there's some locked doors here. It's so dark in here I can't see anything. It's like I'm missing eyes or something. What even is this thing? Oh. Cool. He's just like a floating cloak. Oh, they got pictures of me up in here. A little strange. How do they know who McBad is? Oh, I thought he was gonna be like an NPC. I didn't know I was supposed to avoid him. Okay. Now I know. Follow Banan Boy. Well, here's one of the keys. And assume it's color coordinated, right? Yep. Oh, there's like a pattern. Well, yeah, that would take a bunch of guesses. I wonder where the actual answer would be found. This is a very cool setup, though. I like the, Oh no, it's one of the eyes! This place is far more comfy than the old dungeon I used to live in. Wait, what? Oh. He rolling. What do I do with him? Oh, okay, it was for him. Thank you. Now I will help you so you can see a bit clearer as well. Take this. Still doesn't tell me which ones are in what order. Okay. Oh, this door. Well, that's a big old banana boy. Wait, how do you... Oh. Guess he didn't want anything to do with me? I want to watch the movie. Just a guy ringing a doorbell over and over? I don't think anyone's home, sir. Well, yeah, I like this level a lot. This is definitely set up very interestingly. But how am I supposed to know what order to activate these things in? Goth Bat GF? Who dares to enter my... Oh, it's you. You could really visit me more often, you know. Am I supposed to know who she is? Oh. Are they the same? Yeah, they're the same. Okay. So, top left, bottom right, bottom left. Top left, bottom right. Top left, bottom right. I was definitely, I feel like I was close with my like positioning at one point. Whoa, I had the weirdest dream. No wonder I was sleeping on a key. Yeah, that would probably fuck your sleep up quite a bit if there was a giant fucking key half the size of yourself that you were laying on top of in your bed. Yeah, I would say that would probably fuck up your sleep, yeah. My dude's just trying to live, or not live since he's a mummy, and he's dead, I guess. Oh, the watery factory. It was mentioned in the before times. Oh, all the keys coming together. What kind of bullshit does McBat have to face? Is it gonna be like a Ganondorf fight? I'm trying to like call it now based on what we've already seen, and I'm like, huh, what like N64 tropes have we not seen so far in this? We did it, m'lad. Now before we go in there, I have some flippers for you that will let you move faster underwater. Sounds good, bro. Are we just gonna sit around here all day, or am I gonna go in? Wait, are we sailing in? That doesn't seem like a good idea. Whoa, what is this? The Watery Factory. I mean, it's definitely watery. Who is this guy? I crashed into the wrong game and now my submarine is damaged and it needs some screws to get fixed. Yeah, you're definitely, like, in the wrong game, dude. You need to be in, like, a haunted PS1 game or some shit. I used to make all new water until this melon guy screwed up everything. Who's the melon guy? Whoa, giant bonefish? I'm assuming that's probably something you don't want to touch. I'm so hungry. Look, if you feed me, poor little duck, I might let you bounce on my back, I believe it said. Alright, so he's gonna let us bounce on his back, and you can probably get something from that. Oh yeah, I haven't found any more of the trophy things. Probably missed out on those somewhere. Unfortunately. Do we have like a water limit, you know, like a breath meter thing? Oh, he wanted the, he said now I can become a real star in the sky. He just wanted the, balloon so we could go fly up into the sky. Can't blame him. Dirty water. 40 water. Huh, okay, well, I guess we have to try to plug this up? Or there's one of those hole things that we had to plug it before, so I'm like, maybe that will do something to those corks? I'm not sure. You can just swim right through the bonefish. Oh, it had a screw on the end of it, just like the eel, like the one Mario 64. Star that you can get from, yeah, like the eel swimming around. Well, I need one more screw. Used to fix up all the problems around here, but I can't see a thing with this mask on. So there's gotta be something to roll down, right? To go plug that up? Let's see, where would this last one be? Is there anything we can roll from up here down into the area of the water that has the big hole down there? I'm not thinking so, unfortunately. Oh, but we do have an item. I don't know what this is for or who wanted this. Gonna say, I feel like there couldn't have, you know, not been at least just one spot where I get confused and have to try to figure out what is even happening here. Do I just go into it? No. So what is this that I picked up? It looks like a box of cereal or something. What did this thing want? Oh, he wanted food. Ah, there it is. Okay, I was like, I know we have to give that to somebody most likely. Couldn't remember that it was that guy. All right, I got your screws, dude. Screw yourself. Well, thanks a lot. Now I may be able to get me and my crew back into our own game. God, yeah, there is literally a whole bunch of haunted PS1 games that were themed like around like the sea or whatever for a game jam. I think it was the Haunted Summer, or the Haunted PS1 Summer of Shivers, which I actually made some videos on. I never got around to finishing the last few bit of games from that I wanted to check out. I still probably want to try to do that at some point, just because they're sitting on my PC. Not sure what we're shooting here. Oh! What the fuck? Okay. Nice face, dude. I really wasn't expecting that. I don't love him. He's kind of fucked up. Alright, dude. Thanks for the stamp. Creepy ass motherfucker. Look at that smile. Just rooted in evil.
Ha. Well then, it's time to show you what I'm made of.
So now do we get the secret last? The last level? Glad I kept going with this. Definitely, got something to look forward to in every level here, honestly, as far as just, paying homage to, you know, the N64 stuff. Yeah, let's go into the mystery level. Final boss?
Ha ha ha, are you ready to get squished like the insect you are, little brat? Little bat?
I guess little brat would've worked too.
Oh, he's a mech.
Great fruit of evil, melon king? No, he's the melon emperor. Honestly, what's the fucking difference?
Wait, no, it's hand boss! Hand boss!
You couldn't have had a Nintendo kind of knockoff kind of a game, or an N64 knockoff thing, without having a hand boss. Not knockoff, that's probably the right, or wrong way to put it, but...
Inspired by.
You can't tell me that was it, though. You at least gotta make me do it a couple times, come on. Oh, so he activates these? Oof, is it one and done? Oh no, he just drags you off. Looks like you have to be like pretty spot on with this. Oh, are they resetting? Is that what's going on? Yeah, there's just resetting so you could hit him again. I was kind of worried that it was like on a timer or something.
Whoa, what the hell?
See, this is so cool. Just like very creative little ideas, like, you know, obviously all inspired by things that already exist and whatnot, but just throwing this all together here for like a little homage to the N64 is definitely like, I can't get over it. It's just like I don't know, it's cool. I like shit like this. Just nice and simple and to the point, and you can tell where they got their influences from and such, but it's also some cool creative ideas just for a small little game. Yeah, definitely a good time here. I enjoyed in my McVentures with McBat. McAdventures.
Wow, that was fantastic.
Oh, okay, okay. I will try to be nicer squid in the next game.
Oh, I knew it. You are the hero, after all. Good job. You did it, eh? You didn't find any coins on your way down, right?
Well, my game was more interesting than that old melon. Sorry. Well, that was fun. So what about Kiwi 65 now? Is that a Mario 65 joke? You really took your time. Back in my days, that old melon wouldn't have lasted 2 seconds. Wow, that's... that's rude of you. I just saved everyone's life, and you're gonna, like, talk shit to me like that? That's rude. I'm just glad the melon guy is finally gone. Oh, this guy doesn't want to say anything to me, though. Oh, God. I didn't want to have to see this dude again. Well, it was about time that we were looking for a new home. Well, I guess that, will wrap up our adventures with McBat. Oh, wait, hold on. Can you go out to the submarine guy? Kind of want to see if he has anything. Anything witty to say. Nah, he's just out there. They're just showing you he still exists. He's on his way back to his own game. World completed. Wow, yeah, this was a very fun little game, man. Definitely, glad I checked this out. Game by Marcus Horn. Yeah, I will definitely link this game down in the description below, to the itch.io page. I got it from, Ukraine bundle or whatever on itch.io. I'm not sure. I think that might not still be active or still be going, but this game is only like a couple bucks or something, so honestly I would still say if it looks cool to you and you like, you know, retro N64 kind of stuff, definitely check it out. It's a cool homage, cool game influenced by, you know, some classics that we all love. So yeah, definitely enjoyed this pretty thoroughly. It was a good time. Some interesting characters. Definitely some some interesting kind of rare style, you know, rare N64 kind of looking characters and whatnot, but they did a good job. Did it say there's a bonus book? Like a bonus chapter or something? Oh. Huh. Yeah, I'm not sure what that was, but, it does look like we completed everything, so. Regardless, I think that will be it for, McBat here. Yeah, definitely had a good time with that. Cool to see all the N64 influence. I'm always, you know, a huge nostalgia head for N64 stuff, you know, just kind of how it is. I grew up right around that time, you know, as far as being a kid and, like, getting my first console or whatever. It was an N64. It was the first console that I ever had when I was younger. So definitely have quite a bit of nostalgia for it and whatnot, but... yeah, definitely enjoyed this a lot. It was pretty cool. Glad I checked it out. Like I said, I will link the itch.io page down in the description below. But I just want to take a second to say thank you so much for watching. Really means a lot when anyone takes the time to check out the videos or check out the channel. So thank you so much for checking out the content. Really means a lot. But yeah, I will get out of here. That was McBat64. It was a fun time. But yeah, see you in the next video. Peace out. Get it, you go.